Welcome to LeetCode 30-Day Challenge, Day 1. Today we will solve the problem with three different algorithms from easiest to hard one using three languages: JavaScript, Java, and C++. In addition, we will learn how Xor operation works. So, my name is Alexander Zelenin and I'm experienced software engineer. Let's start. First, we will observe the problem itself. It's called single number. Given a non-empty array of integers, every element appears twice except for one. Find that single one. Do we have two examples? 2-2-1, where 1 is the answer, and 4-1-2-1-2, where 4 is an answer. If you already understand the problem, go to the description, click to the link to the problem, and try to solve it by yourself. After that, go back to video and check. If you're expecting any problems, here is the bonus test cases for you. We have just one element, positive, zero, and negative. The answer is located in different places, in start, in middle, and we have one of base one where the answer in the end, where we have negative answer in different location, where we have positive answer and negative integers in the array, and couple of maximum integer values just to check for overflow. So first we will solve the problem with the pretty straightforward algorithm using JavaScript. We will go through every number, starting with the first one, 4, and we will check it against every other number. There is no other number equal to 4, so the 4 is an answer. But if the 4 will be the last number, we will have a lot of checks. We will have exactly O(n) square checks with it, which is not optimal. But still, this is solution. So we can improve this algorithm. We'll go with Java next. This time we will use a hashmap. If you already know how to solve it using hashmap, try to do it by yourself or write in the comments. So we creating the hashmap and we putting every number in this hashmap and we counting them. Like at this moment we have two number one and one number four. After this we can go through this hash map and check how many numbers we have. So we have one number four, that means that's an answer, done. So let's try with the fastest approach using C++. We will go to use Xor operation. First, we need to represent every number as set of bits. For example, 2 will be represented like this. The first digit represent is it negative or positive number, and 1, 0 represent 2, so it's 2. And as initial answer, we have 0. So 0 is all zeros. And we will apply XOR operation. XOR operation result number to 1 only if one of numbers is 1 and another is 0. So we have here only one such combination, 1 and 0, that results to pretty same number, because XOR operation with 0 results the same number. So as temporary answer we have 2. On the second step we represent -1. it will be the first to represent minus. We have the first digit as 1 and the last one also 1. It will be minus 1. And we have 2. We perform Xor operation, and now you can see that we have 3 cases where we have 1 and 0. And this number will be encoded to minus 3, because we have 3 and 1 in the start means it's negative. Then we have number 2. And we perform XOR with number 2. And what is interesting, now we just remove both of our numbers 2. So you can see that our answer is minus 1. And if it will be the end of our array, we already found an answer of minus 1. So when we perform next operation, these numbers are the same and they just destroy each other, which result to 0. And as we already know, any number XOR 0 will be the same number. Sorry, there is mistake in the animation. So we have 4 as an answer. If you like this new format, please like and subscribe. Also, if you have any ideas, write in the comments. Also, you can submit your answer and maybe we will review it in one of next videos. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.